When you first start learning to code, you might feel guilty for using Google to figure out how to do simple things. But after 10 years of experience, you'll be so skilled at suppressing your guilt that you just won't feel bad for cheating anymore. Some people say a software engineer is just a professional Google searcher, and that's 100% true. 10x developers are smart enough to know that memorizing syntax, algorithms, and data types can be a waste of time. It's more efficient to just Google the information you need on demand. But Googling it is an art form, and in this video, we'll look at 10 tips to Google stuff like a 10x developer. What usually happens is you're coding along, and then some crazy error message pops up and ruins your day. You copy the message, paste it into Google, and what you find is that developers have been Googling the same error message for hundreds of years, and it overlaps across multiple frameworks and programming languages. One easy way to refine your search is to simply wrap it in quotes. That tells Google to search for an exact match, when normally it does a more fuzzy match looking for synonyms and related terms. Because in many cases, you're looking for that one lucky person that had that same weird error who was brave enough to post it on Stack Overflow. And if you're a content creator, you can use quotes to see who's plagiarizing your content. That's useful, but another problem you might encounter is that you're on a documentation site that has a really bad insight search or maybe none at all. If you only want results from the site, enter site:URL followed by your search term. That's also really useful for tracking down a result you saw on GitHub or Stack Overflow in the past. Sometimes when you search though, the results might be dominated by one popular related topic like jQuery, the king of the JavaScript frameworks. You can exclude a term from the results by simply adding a minus in front of it. That's also useful for eliminating unnecessary terms like your own custom class names from an error message. Now, if you happen to be getting a lot of results about jQuery, they were probably written many years ago. You can filter this older content out with the after operator to only return results that were published after a specific date. Or on the flip side, you may be maintaining a legacy project, in which case you only want results before a certain date. It's also possible to search a range of dates, or any numbers for that matter, by putting two dots in between them. That one can be useful to find old announcements or releases, but you're not too sure when they actually came out. Or maybe you happen to be migrating from a legacy React project, and you're comparing Svelte with Solid.js. Use the pipe operator to search for one or the other. And you can also wrap it in parentheses to group it, and then apply another search term along with it. Another Google search operator that seems kind of useless at first is the wildcard. You might use it to search how to design an anything with Tailwind. But it can come into play with other operators like site, where I'm adding it here as the subdomain to find all of the subdomains that live on fireship.io. When searching a site, I might also want a specific file type, like maybe I'm looking for a PDF in a regular Google search, or maybe I only want GIF files when doing an image search. The file type operator makes that possible. But what if you're like a black hat hacker that wants to search fringe stuff, like how to do SQL injection, how to hack the software on birds, or maybe you just want to learn how they filmed the moon landing? For this kind of stuff, Google results are carefully crafted to gaslight you.
Gaslighting doesn't exist, you made it up because you're f***ing crazy.
To pierce through the establishment. You'll need to use a search engine like DuckDuckGo, or go directly to alternative media like Odyssey. DuckDuckGo supports all of these same operators, by the way. I'm just kidding though, you should definitely use Google.
Establishment, establishment, you always know what's best.
You suck! Learn the rules!
If you are a developer, that means you probably have a blog, but it can be really hard to make a blog stand out. If you want to see what your competitors are up to, you can use the related operator to find websites that are similar to yours or to a specific blog post. And one other cool thing you might want to do is find out if Google has cached the latest version of your website. To do that, put your website in front of the cache operator, and now you can see your website as Google currently sees it. And there you have 10 ways to use Google like an elite software engineer. Hit like and subscribe for more developer tips every week. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.